I suppose that all of you know what a hyperbola is. But first we will define it using a particular definition. For the definition, we will use a simple construction. So we have taken the axis. Now we will draw the hyperbola. Now, so let's draw it here. Now we will take two very specific points. Those two points are very important for any conic section, I mean especially for hyperbola, that is the focus of the hyperbola. Here those are two focus of the hyperbola. Now to define the hyperbola, we will take a point on the hyperbola here and we will join the two focuses with it. So let's join S1A and S2A here. Now the defining property of hyperbola is that the difference of the red line and the blue line equals to some constant. It varies for different hyperbolas. Now let's judge them using a simple visual approach. Now you will move the red point along the hyperbola, and as you can see, the red part of the line along the right side is always constant, and that is the 4 cm. Now using this property, you can construct the hyperbola even using a string. Now we will see another definition of hyperbola which uses a conic. So now let's see how we will define it. To see the another definition of the hyperbola, let's draw the axis. Now let's go to 3D view. Now we will draw a double cone, that is a conic. Now let's draw the conic first here. Now as you have already, I suppose, learned before, that if I cut this conic with a plane, then it will construct a hyperbola. As you can see, for the orientation of the plane, just like this, we have constructed a hyperbola. Let me trace out the hyperbola here. So using a cone and a plane, we can construct a hyperbola. Now we will see why this definition and the previous one are same. So we will approach this in a visual and a little geometric way. Using a conic and a plane, we can create a hyperbola. Let me show you it once again. Here is a cone and here is another one, and if I cut these two cones using a plane in a particular way, we will create a hyperbola, as you can see. Now we have also seen that the distance difference from a point on the hyperbola to both its focus is constant. So this is another definition, and we will be using this constant difference property to prove that we can create a hyperbola using a plane and a conic. Now 3Blue1Brown channel has the same video on ellipses, and that one is also pretty beautiful, so you can watch that one also. Now let me show you the curve which is created because of the intersection. It is actually the hyperbola, but we will assume that we don't know, and we will be proving that it is indeed a hyperbola. So here is one and here is another one. So these two curves are actually on the surface of the plane. As you can see from the upper view here, they are actually on the surface of the plane, and the deep curve, that is the blue curve, is also on the surface of the plane and the cone. Now to prove this, we will be needing a special construction, and we will draw two spheres such that they are tangent with the plane on a particular point and also tangent with the cone. So let me draw those spheres out. So here is one sphere and here is another one. So these two spheres are tangent with the plane, as you can see from the upper view, that it's like the red one is a circle and a purple line is tangent to it. Now because of the circular symmetry of the sphere and the cone, they will touch each other along a circle, and those two circles will be very important for our proof. So let me draw those out here is one and here is another one. So along these two circles, the sphere has touched the cone. So these two green circles are actually on the surface of the cone and also on the surface of the sphere. Now there is another two important points for our proof. Remember, I have told you that the sphere is touching the plane on a particular point. So for each sphere we will get two points, and those two points are actually on the surface of the sphere and also on the surface of the plane. So let me draw those out. So here is one and here is another one, as you can see. So these two points are on the surface of the sphere and also on the surface of the plane, and I am sure that you have already guessed that these two points are actually the points of focus, that is the focuses of our hyperbola. This curve, we don't know yet that it is a hyperbola. So these two points are the points on which the plane is tangent with the sphere. Now to begin our proof, we will take a point on the blue curve. So let me take a point with a yellow color on the curve here. Now let's join those two points, that is the green point with the yellow point. So here I have connected it using a blue line. Now those two points are on the plane. So those two points are on the plane. So if we connect them using a line, that line will be also on the plane. And remember that I have told you that the plane is tangent with the sphere on the point D, that is the green point, as you can see. On the point, they are actually tangent. So because the line is also on the plane and the plane is tangent with the sphere on that particular point, so any line joining the green point with any other point on the plane will be tangent to the sphere. So I hope that it is clear that the blue line is tangent to the sphere. Now we will take another point on the green circle, and that point will be also very important. So let me draw that out. Here it is. Now we will also join the blue point, that is our new blue point, with the yellow point. So let me draw that out with a black line here. Now because the yellow point is outside the sphere, because it is on the plane and the plane is only tangent with the red sphere, so we are drawing a line, that is a tangent line, from the yellow point, that which is outside the sphere, on the sphere, that is the blue line. And the green circle is also tangent with the sphere, because along that line the cone and the spheres are tangent to each other. So if I connect those two points, which is on the green circle and another point which is on the cone, so we are drawing a tangent along the surface of the cone, and that is tangent with the sphere. So the black line is also tangent to the sphere, and the black line is situated on the surface of the cone. This should be remembered because we will need this information for our proof. Now remember that we have another point, that is the another focus. So we will also connect the lower focus with the yellow point. So let's draw it. Here it is. Now we know from our 2D knowledge that if I draw tangents from a point to a circle, then each tangent, that is the line of tangency, will have equal length. Same is true for 3D. If I draw tangent from a point which is outside a sphere to the surface of the sphere, then
each tangent line have equal length. So what we are doing, we are drawing two tangents from the yellow point to the surface of the upper sphere. So the small blue line and the small black line have equal length. So their lengths are equal. Now what we have done, we have drawn another line from a point Q which is outside the lower red sphere. So that yellow line will be also tangent to the lower red sphere. Why? Because those two points are on the purple plane. So the line joining them will also be on the purple plane. And the plane is tangent with the lower sphere on that particular point, that is the lower green point, our lower focus. So that line will also be tangent to our sphere. Now we will take another tangent by taking a point on the lower circle. Here it is the T, and we will draw another tangent from the upper yellow point to the point T. So let me draw that out. Here it is the blue point or blue line. So we have two tangents from the point yellow point to the lower sphere. One is yellow colored line and another one is blue colored line. So these two lines are actually tangent to the same sphere from the same point. So they will have equal length. Now, if I now calculate the difference of length of the big yellow line minus the small blue line, then what you will get? So what we are doing, we are calculating the difference of length of the big yellow line minus the small blue line. So it will be equal to the difference of length of the big blue line, because that big blue line has equal length with the big yellow line, minus the length of the small black line, because the small black line has equal length, that is this small black line. This small black line has equal length with the small blue line. So what we are doing is the length difference, or we are calculating the length difference of the big blue line minus the small black line, and those two lines are on the surface of the cone. So we will get a line which is connecting the upper blue point with the lower point T along the surface of the cone. So let me draw that out. So here is our segment which is actually connecting those two lines. So their difference will be equal to the length of this red segment. Now the red segment is actually the latent height of the cone whose base are those two yellow circles. So for a particular case, this red line have always a constant length. So we have just proved that the difference of the length of the yellow line minus the difference of the length of the blue small line is equal to the length of a red segment which is always a constant. And how we know it is a constant? Because there are only a unique circle along which the sphere is touching the cone, and for the two cones and spheres we are getting two circles. So those will have, and along the cone those will have always constant latent height. And so if I draw the cone which is connecting them, you can see that they are actually tangents. So let me hide all of this and let me just draw the cone. So as you can see, that there is a cone which is created because of the two green circles. And as you can see, if I move this, the height of the red line is always constant. It's like it is rotating just, and the rotation does not change the length of any line. So you can see that the difference of length of the yellow big line minus the difference the length of the small blue line is equals to the length of the red line, which is always a constant for our particular case. And hence it proves that it satisfies the definition that the any point from the blue on the blue curve, the line joining from the any point on the blue curve to the both focuses or the two special points to the both focuses of the two special points are actually a constant, and that is equal to the red line, and hence it ends our proof. Seen that a totally different method can also create the same hyperbola, and as you can see in the screen, there are many methods to create it, and I hope you have enjoyed its beauty and you can try it yourself to prove the other ones. Okay, bye for today.